Hi there, welcome back to the channel. Ever since OpenAI released ChatGPT, there has been a lot of hype around the generative AI. Most of the other companies are trying to create products and services around generative AI, and we see infusion of GenAI in every product and every service by different cloud providers. There are scenarios where you might want to run these models locally on your machine. Now the question is it possible to run a generative AI model or GenAI model or large language model on your laptop or on your workstation? It is possible, and there might be circumstances where due to security reasons or due to things like data privacy, you might not want to use these online models or the models which are hosted on the public internet. So there is a series of open source models which are provided on sites like Hugging Face, which you can download and you can run on your own workstation. If you're looking for this kind of a solution, then this video is the right choice for you. Let's get started. But before we start with the running of large language models, I would like you to request to subscribe to this channel. We see that a lot of people who are watching these videos, they have not yet subscribed. And I would really appreciate if you hit the like button if you find these videos useful. With that, let's see what do we need to get started with running the models on your workstation. There is one option which is provided by Meta or Facebook, and they published this thing called Ollama or Llama. If we head over to the ollama.com, we can see that it gives us these options of running large language models. This could be like Llama 3.1, it could be Phi, it could be Minstrel, it could be Gemma. So these are the different models which are available. The easiest way to get started is to hit this download button, and this particular Ollama option or Ollama user interface is supported for macOS, Linux, and Windows. I'm running a M2 Mac, so I can download straight away the version which is available for macOS. But if you know from previous experience of watching videos on this channel, I like to use the package manager, and on Mac, I use Brew as the package manager. Luckily, there is a Brew package or Homebrew package for Ollama. We can easily search for Ollama with brew search Ollama command, and we see that Ollama as a formula is available, and there is also the user interface or GUI, which is a cask which is available as Ollama. We can also look at the info using brew info command, and it will tell us that currently it is not installed. This particular package is published by ollama.com, and it will tell us what is the license and all the dependencies. So let's go ahead and quickly install this. Now when I install, there is an option to provide --cask as a flag if you want to install it as a GUI, or I can also install Ollama without the GUI, or it will not set up the user interface for us. I intend to use Ollama mainly from the terminal, but if you are more of a user interface friendly person, you can provide the --cask flag. All it does is it sets up the Ollama GUI for us, and when we start that GUI, it will provide us the option to install the CLI. Once we have this Ollama installed using Homebrew here, the advantage here using Homebrew is anytime there is an update to the Ollama version, I don't have to go to the browser and look for a particular operating system. I can just come onto the terminal and use the package manager and say what is the outdated version. It will tell me the list of softwares which I've installed using Brew. And if there is an updated version of Ollama, I can easily upgrade it from the command line itself. Let's see what are the flags which are supported by Ollama. We have the serve option where it starts Ollama and it starts like a service. So the other applications, they can interact with the Ollama as a service, and we will see how to do this. There is also the option to create a model based on a model file. We have the show option to show the details or the information about a model. We can run a model and we can push and pull. So if you look at these commands, these are more or less similar to the Docker command where we have Docker run, Docker pull, Docker push, Docker list kind of commands. And the terminology or the philosophy seems to be similar in terms of building these models where they have different layers associated with the model file. So how do we look for the models, or how do we find the models? This is again quite easy to look for the models. When we go back to the ollama.com website, We have the models option here, and we can also look at other things like the documentation at the bottom. There is the link to the GitHub project. There is also the Discord option if we want to connect to the team and use the instant chat. So we are looking at different models which are supported by Ollama, and there is the Llama 3.1, which is one of the featured model. We can also filter based on what are the most popular models or the newest model, and we will go with the featured models for the time being. Llama 3.1 is the model created by Facebook, and it has got three different versions, or it's created by Meta, and it's available in three different versions: 8 billion parameters, 70 billion and 405 billion parameters. Let's go into the details of this and see what does it mean, or how can we start using this. Here we are looking at the 8 billion parameters based model. This was updated about 4 days ago, and we can see different parameters, what's the template used for invoking this model, and other information in terms of how is the model evaluation done and various other things. Now, before we start using this, there are some prerequisites which we have to be aware of, and these are mainly to do with the amount of resources which are required. As I said, you can run this locally on your workstation or on your laptop, but you need to have certain amount of RAM available. If you are going to use a 7 billion model, we can see here that the minimum RAM which is required, available RAM, should be 8 GB. It doesn't mean that you have a 8 GB RAM for your machine and you can use it. We definitely need more than 8 GB RAM, because other system processes and other resources would be, or other applications would be, using this RAM. Fortunately, I have got more than 8 GB RAM available on my machine, so I can run this 7 billion model. If we are going with the 13 billion parameters based model, we need at least 16 GB of available RAM. And then when we are going with 33 billion parameters, we need at least 32 GB of RAM available. So as we see, as we go higher up the number of parameters, we need more and more RAM to execute those. And in some cases, some of these models, they also require the GPU support. So here we can see some of the examples, like Llama 3.1, Phi 3 Mini, there is Phi Medium version, Gemma 2, Mistral, Starling, Code Llama. These are the different models which are documented on the GitHub page for Ollama, and these are the same ones we would see in the library as well. So now we know what models are available. Let's see how to use one of these models. So I'm going to use Llama 3.1 as the option, and here if I want to use Llama 3.1, when I click on this, you will see that the option to run that particular model is using this command, Ollama run Llama 3.1. So when I do this, it is similar to the Docker. As I said, we need the model file to be downloaded. If the file doesn't exist, then it will automatically download the file. But before we do that, we also need Ollama service to be running. So I can say Ollama serve here, that is to start the server, or to start it as a service. Now we have the Ollama service running. Let's go and run the Ollama run command again, and we will see Llama 3.1. And here, what has happened is I already have downloaded this one, because this particular file is quite big in size. So let me just say bye here to come out of this. And let me show you the list of models that I have first before we invoke the Ollama run. So I can use Ollama list command to list the models which I've downloaded from the models repository. And you can see here it is Llama 3.1, the latest version of that, of size 4.7 GB, has been downloaded about 4 hours ago. My internet connection is a bit slow here. That's why I pre-downloaded this. But if you don't have this particular model, then it will download the complete model file, and only then you will be able to run this. So to run it, it is pretty simple. We run the Ollama run Llama 3.1 command, and we see that it is asking us to send a message. I'm currently based in Melbourne, so let's ask something which is Melbourne related, and let's say, how is the weather in Melbourne during the month of September? And I have a small typo there, but looks like the GenAI is working fine here. It is giving me the answer that Melbourne, Australia's second largest city, experiences a temperate climate with four distinct seasons. During September, Melbourne typically enjoys mild and pleasant weather, making it ideal time to visit. It also tells me what is the average high and low temperature, which varies from 9 to 18 degrees. And as you can see from my attire, I'm wearing a hoodie here because of the slightly cold weather today. September is a transitional month, and it gives various other information, which means that this model is working fine. Now, I'm new to Melbourne, so let's ask one more follow-up question here. How do you greet people in Aussie style? And let's make it again specific to Melbourne. Maybe there are different ways in different regions of Australia that people greet one another. So here we can see there are again different options which are provided to us. Where is it? Yeah, so I asked the question here, how do you greet people in Aussie style in Melbourne? Greeting people like a true blue Melbournian. Okay, yeah. Melbourne local requires some Aussie flair. So that's good to know. And that is around saying things like mate. Mate is quite a common word here used in Australia. So here are some of the tips how to greet people in a way that's uniquely Melbournian. Good day, mate. How are you going? And this I can relate to because my cousin who's lived here for quite a long time, he usually starts with this. So I can very well relate to this particular phrase. And there are different variations as well. You can use hey, then name of the person, how is it going, good on you. And then there is also various other options and Aussie slangs which are specified here. With that, we can clearly see that the model is working as expected. And we can also go back onto the other tab in this particular warp terminal, and we can see the details which is shown in the terminal output. So here, when we start running the Llama 3.1 model, we can see that it's showing some debug kind of information. And these are some of the API related calls or API methods supported. And as we start interacting with that particular model, we see that it does output a lot of information for us. And the last part, which is quite helpful, is here is where that chat API is being called when we start asking those things like, how do we greet people in Melbourne, or how are the seasons in Melbourne? We can see it is running just a couple of minutes back. It is 3:55 here. So about 2 minutes back, these API calls have been made, and that is how we can understand, or we can confirm that it is actually hitting the model files, or it is actually interacting with the model. So that was about how do we run the model using Ollama. There are other options as well, but Ollama is one of the popular ones. And in one of the future videos, we will definitely go ahead and use the other options to showcase how to interact or how to use these generative AI models locally. Now, there is one more thing I would like to show here. And the reason why I started using the local model was I have this ChatGPT. It's a tool which I use to analyze the Kubernetes cluster. And in here, I can configure a local AI provider. I can use this particular GenAI model or generative AI model using the provider as local AI. And then I can interact with ChatGPT. I can use Ollama's Llama 3.1 model as the backend. And that I would showcase how to interact or how to configure it in a separate video. That's a precursor to that upcoming video. If you would like to know about that video, it's a good time again to subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching this. I hope you found this useful. So what we did in this particular video was to install the Ollama as a package using Homebrew, using brew install, which again is a very handy way of installing and updating the software instead of using the browser based option or downloading and installing the software using GUI based approach. Then we downloaded the model, which is the Llama 3.1. We used the Ollama run command to run that particular model, and we also interacted with the model. So with that, we come to the end of this video. Hope you found it useful. Please hit the like button if you find these videos useful. Thanks for watching this. I'll see you in the next one.